So sorry about that. Oh gosh. Yeah, where was I? Take two. Where was I? Yeah, Dr. Selena is in discussions with the anaesthetist as the best way to get me in and out of consciousness safely, knowing the increased risks of, I know when I've been really bad, that they make you sign off all the normal forms for a surgery, but then you have to sign off an extra one, acknowledging that you've been told that you're high risk at the moment and you're aware of what that means, and it's basically signing your life away. It's hard to do, and now because of COVID, the wonderful thing that it is, no one can come in with me. I have to be dropped off at the hospital, and that is the last I will see of Dev, or anyone else that's not got scrubs on. So Deb will have to wait for a phone call to know if I'm okay after surgery, to know that I made it out okay. And the next phone call he'll get in, I've been told, minimum a week, maximum open-ended, will be to come get me. And it's so hard because I'm so vulnerable, and I've been I have so much medical based trauma, and I have to go through this alone. I can't have anyone advocating for me. I can't. I've got to trust that this time it'll be different. I've got to. It's, yeah. They're gonna, when I'm under, they're gonna place a feeding tube, obviously. I'm literally could have kissed her through the bloody video chat. She's doing me a solid, and I'm putting the tube in while I'm unconscious, so I don't have to deal with the added shit of that getting put in awake. And then I'll be monitored for refeeding syndrome, which is inevitable. Nutritionist and a dietitian go just fine tune exactly what I need and how I'm going to get that, any other things that they feel like they should want to test or check on the way, bone density or just whatever the hell. Like, I'm hoping that I can talk to someone in regards to my memory recall and cognitive issues, short-term memory, not knowledge recall, two that are really, really, I don't know how to tackle it. Like, I don't know what to do or like ways to help myself through that. Also, I'm having trouble connecting what I'm thinking to how to communicate it, and like flares of anger about this, and I end up like bursting out because I can't figure out, like, it's like I'm hiding behind this frosted glass. I can see the message or what the bit of information, and I can't get my mouth, and I've always been like a very avid communicator, and this rage, this like this frustration that not being able to do something that is so intrinsic to me, so base, like it just flares, like I it's very ugly, and I don't like that. I want a way to help myself not put that on anyone else to manage it. I don't know how long I'm going to have that or if it's permanent. Just a better way to be. Like, if this is all I get, I want a way to make this the best and best kind of experience that I can make it, I guess. Anyway, so I'll be on that. When I'm released, I'll be on feeds for who knows, however long it takes, months, before I'm at a place where we can talk about where Dr. Selena is happy that, and the surgical team is happy that I won't just die on an operating table. Where the risk is more balanced to start addressing how we're going to take on this many layered and issue that is not going to get fixed. But that's a bit hard to digest, I guess. That's a bit of a hard one. Something that probably can't be fixed. More something that can be managed. There's no better for me. There's never going to be a better. There's going to be an okay, I guess. There's going to be, I'm going to be able to get more of myself back, I guess. More, I'm going to be able to get more independence. I'm going to have to make a new okay. But this is forever altered, the path of my life. And who I could be, who I was hoping to be, who I was aiming to be, what I wanted for myself. I'll never know. I'm never going to know. But what I have been trying to do for a little bit now, and I'll keep doing, is how to make what is fulfilling. I want to be able to look back and not go, it's okay for that. And like, it was good for what it was. I want a way to look at my life and have no regrets, and it be enough, and to be happy with what is, truly happy, because I don't think there's any other way to be. There's no other way. I don't want to, it was good for what I could get. I need it. I need a way to create a life that isn't okay. It isn't. Like a plan B. I'm trying to create a life that is truly enough, and it is. Brings me joy, and not just joy because that's the limit of joy. Like, I can get out of it, like, true fulfillment and joy with what I do have, because I'm only 33 years old. There's a lot of things pending, I guess, but potentially I have a lot of time left, and I don't want, the weight of what was lost, what has been lost, I don't want that to be the dominant feature of every day that I get. So, I think I'm getting there. Like, what I've started to build for myself and what I can do and what is in this. If this is all I get, if I don't get too much worse, if I, the way my mind works and my body works, I'm starting, and I'll promise you, I'll fill all you guys in. That'll be like a nice video if you want to, all things pending, out of hospital and getting some nutrients in with my old, you know, you guys can get snorkel face tube tash back again. Well, so wheels and swings and roundabouts. Sorry. It was really important that I make this video for you guys. Because I don't know if and when I'm going to be able to write down to get in touch again, and if I'll be able to write back if you guys get in touch just for a little bit. If you're in Melbourne and suffocating under this like 1984 style lockdown, I'm with you. If you're not wearing a mask, cool, your choice, but your choice is condemning me to have to face a lot of stuff alone I shouldn't have to, and have and be cut off from support that my carer, my partner and I need. And you're making that choice for me and for us. It's really, really uncool. Yeah. Be good to each other, please. I'm really trying to have like the usual energy I have, but like I have nothing left. Just keep being kind, please. And fingers crossed I'll see you on the other side.